Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology. I'm climatologist Lynette Bedio.
And I'm hydrologist Robert Pippenich. We're here to discuss the August to October climate and water outlook. Lynette, it's been a pretty wet start to the year, although fairly dry June. How are the climate drivers looking?
So we're seeing those cooler temperatures in the tropical Pacific. Once we get past certain levels, yeah, it's indicative of a La Nina event. We're not quite there yet, but the Bureau is at a La Nina watch, which means that there's double the normal chance of a La Nina event occurring. So a La Nina event usually brings wetter than average conditions over Australia. And as you said, we have had a wetter start to the year. So looking at that 6 month map there, last time we spoke, we had those wetter conditions leading into winter. So we have had a dry June, but still overall, we're seeing wetter than average conditions in some parts. And with the wetter July, we're hoping that this will continue. So how's this impacted on the soil moisture?
Yeah, so looking at the soil moisture map for June, we can see that the southeast corner of the country is still relatively wet with you know, around average to above average soil moisture conditions. That's come off a little bit in June from very wet conditions in May. Then looking across to the south of the country and the southwest corner, we see very dry soils there. So the catchments there are very dry and minimal runoff would be generated there with any rainfall. So given the possibility of the La Nina, what's the rainfall outlook like?
We are seeing that increased chance of above average rainfall across much of Australia, especially in the east there, but parts of southwest WA, which have been very dry recently. So really hoping for that rainfall to really continue that recovery from those really dry drought conditions that we saw last year. How's this looking for streamflow?
Yeah, so the streamflow for our July to September outlook, we're seeing around 2/3 of locations likely to be low or near median. The low flows include a concentration in the southwest. That's in line with the dry catchments we saw in the soil moisture map earlier. Going across to the southeast, that's where we're seeing most of the near median and high flows concentrated. Again, in line with a sort of near average to above average soil moisture conditions there. Looking up at the north, we're seeing a lot of a high concentration of that new normal flow category there. And that's indicative of the dry season, given that that category represents very low flows where there's a roughly equal chance of representing either of the three low or near median or high category. So looking ahead to the temperature outlook, how's that looking?
Yeah, thanks. We're seeing increased chances of above average daytime temperatures across much of the northern part of Australia and into the far southeast there. Nighttime temperatures, increased chances of above average nighttime temperatures across much of the country, though it is still winter, so we're still going to get those cold nights.
Of course, yeah. Okay, thanks, Lynette. That's it from us for now. Join us again for our climate and water conversation.